林思英两位同学带来的 Eye of the Beholder Beauty Standards Taiwan vs. America，
aesthetically.
Some of us may agree with such a definition, others may not. And that's totally okay, but we can all agree that beauty is everywhere. Beauty exists in nature, such as this peacock with its vibrant feathers, and in what humankind creates, like this painting by Picasso, The Weeping Women. But beauty is not only restricted to sight, as in the case of music.I'm thinking out loud, maybe we found love right where we are. However, what each person defines as beautiful varies.
So, let's go back to that painting by Picasso. Personally, I'm not a huge fan of Picasso's painting, and I don't really see the rage over them. But hey, somebody out there must have, because this painting was actually sold for $2 million.It's worth even more now. I couldn't even afford it with all the money that I make in my lifetime.
Well, same for me too.
So, this brings us to the core of our presentation. Beauty is in the eye of the beholder.
To illustrate the differences between American and Taiwanese beauty standards, we're going to get the help from the 21st century trend.
Selfies. First, let's take a look at the American selfie. Here we have American singer and actress Selena Gomez.
Who says you're not beautiful? Who says?
Americans love tan skin. Skin tone is a sign of socioeconomic status. Having tan skin means that you have the time and money to go on vacation in order to procure such a tan.
Tanning salons earn millions every year.
Besides, who wouldn't want to go and go?
America is also known for being crazy obsessed about their teeth. Not that you could really see Selena's teeth in this picture, so here's another selfie. That's much better. Okay, so as you can see, having good teeth really improves your smile, and having a great smile lights up your face.
In fact, America is famous for having the most number of people wearing braces.
America's predilection for curvy bodies is not just about liking something sexy.The University of Texas has done a study and found that human brains are actually hardwired for curvy bodies because shapely figures are associated with fertility.
I'm in love with the shape of you. I'm in love with your body.
As for high cheekbones and mature eyes, both these traits are preferred because it shows that you are grown up and you've reached the age of sexual maturity.
This is the reason why American makeup styles is more on the bold side, like this smoky eye. Now, let's focus on the Taiwanese selfie. Representing Taiwan is Taiwanese actress Zhou Chen. Big eyes.
Hey there, pretty brown eyes. What you do later tonight?
And a high nose bridge are signs of westernization.
That's right, in Taiwan, makeup is usually used to enlarge people's eyes.And contour their noses. In Taiwan, skin tone is also a sign of socioeconomic status.
But unlike Americans, Taiwanese people prefer having light skin. The preference for light skin comes from the idea that those who work in the fields were more tan. So the lighter you are, the wealthier you are.
Taiwanese people go to extreme lengths to maintain their pure white skin. If you go on the Watson's website and type in whitened skin, you will find 186 pages of results filled with beauty products to whiten your skin. You will also see Taiwanese people out and about with an umbrella, even on days when it's not raining. Or you're going to see them wearing these Darth Vader-like visors or motorcycle sleeves.
Taiwanese people are all about youthfulness, and having a V-shaped chin makes you look longer, younger.
So, how old do you guys think Jo Chen is? Can you believe she's actually 38 years old? She looks like a 20-year-old, like us.
Well, in contrast to the American robust figure, Taiwanese people prefer having a slim body, because a slim figure goes with a, you know, natural, decent, or innocent look.
Now, let's look at the bigger picture. Placing the selfies side by side, we can see that Taiwanese people go for a more innocent and cute look, while Americans are after something more sultry and exuberant.
So as you can see, beauty is in the eye of the beholder. Every culture has its own beauty standard.
And just to point out, even when skin tone are both symbols of socioeconomic status in both cultures, in America, tan skin is what shows that you're wealthy. But in Taiwan, light skin is what shows you're wealthy.
But our quest for beauty is not without cost.
For example, in places where being skinny is what's considered beautiful, cases of anorexia nervosa and bulimia are increasing at frightening rates. In Taiwan, the number of eating disorder cases have doubled in the last 5 years.
Skin cancer is also becoming a major problem in countries where tans are what's fabulous. It might be surprising, but the number of skin cancer cases due to tanning is actually greater than the number of lung cancer cases due to smoking.
So just remember, beauty is never worth sacrificing your health over.
Your body is precious. It is your vehicle for awakening.
Treat it with care.
There's a hope to see for you in the dark. You should know you're beautiful just the way you are. And you don't have to change a thing. The world could change its heart. No scars, see you're beautiful. We're stars and we're beautiful.
Oh. I'm Kim and I'm Joyce. Thank you for watching.